people are shocked because they think art is somehow sacred.
You either love them or hate them. It's not the anti-eterno of the painting world, really, is it?
Dilwyn Thomas sort of a Welsh painting. I mean, he's got that sort of rage and that power in his work.
This is a real artist. This is someone who cannot stop expressing himself.
In the spring of 2001, this painting by Neale Howells gained international exposure, having been chosen by the Manic Street Preachers for the cover of their new album. This film follows Neale over the ensuing 3 months, a new eventful phase in his career that saw him break out of Wales in search of a wider audience for his work. But to the Welsh art world, the boy from Melyn, Neath, had already achieved notoriety. His unorthodox methods and contentious works have led to cancelled shows and a hostile press. But there's no bigger critic for the work than Neale himself.
This is what we're doing this morning as well, but slightly more late yesterday. See, that, this is a prime example of a failure of a picture. Trying to do something, you know. Whoa, look at that, then. Look at that. That's... But don't try and intentionally make something which sits comfortably for myself on the eye. I'm trying to find out a new picture. There's a picture there, right? And I've got to find it. You know, I'm going to try. I've got to kind of coax it out, like.
Neale Howells started attracting attention in 1997 when he was taken on by the progressive Washington Gallery in Penarth. His work divided opinion, but won enough admirers to keep him coming back and selling.
We basically put it over the writing.
Yeah. He certainly, to me, represents a divide between, say, the Welsh landscape tradition, but then comes this sort of urban kind of renegade who has looked at Wales in its modern context, and he is important, he is significant. He's picking up from all over where he lives, and anywhere he goes, he's picking up the materials to paint with and to paint on.
See, here we are, look at that. See, we can use things like this. This is all rubbish, but we can use that.
Through this quite sort of quirky brain of his, there's some sort of osmosis. And I think all of that gets spilled onto these often quite massive works.
Look at this colour, you know, these two colours together. They're very close to complementing each other. And it's natural, you know. This is what it's all about. You don't make things, really. You discover them. And that's a bit of discovery there, you know.
Neale has that kind of automatic writing quality. Direct from the brain, direct from the spirit, you might say, and things and ideas which in some way shock the viewer into a new realization. Shock in terms of the use of the shapes, the colours, the lines, and the forms in the works.
I mean, sometimes I like painting blindfold, you know, with my eyes closed or something, just to see what comes out, try to get away from doing things which is contrived or something. I mean, sometimes I even turn the picture upside down, and so I don't even know which way I'm working on it. But see, I've got my eyes closed now. Not a clue.
I'm sure that I'll have friends and family who'll come around and say, "What a bit of rubbish! You know, anyone can do that." The point is, they can't. They can't even begin to start to do something like this. You're going to get something awful that looks hideous. I guarantee it. Unless, of course, one has a bit of undiscovered flair.
Well, this is 1994. So this is just before I had that huge turning point in my life of the Slade and the got getting in. I went for an interview and I got, you know, I just had a sort of moment of clarity there. And he goes, what's this work about? And I was saying, well, this is represents this. And I was looking at him and I was saying, bullshit, I'm talking crap. What the fuck am I doing here? Like, you know, what am I talking about? You? And then it just went on like that. And I thought, fuck it. Yeah, so I left out there and I was so, I don't know if it was like the trees, I knew it was a fuck up. But as the weeks went on, I thought, brilliant. You didn't have to prove to anybody anything anymore. Like, you're doing your own work. It was that point. It's fantastic, it was. I did my MA year. In 5 years, like, constantly working on my books. I didn't need to go to the slate, did I?
Master of Arts, me. Melyn Shay.
The people who are attracted to Neale's work immediately warm to his anarchy. These people like rampant chaos in their works, and that's what they get with Neale. They get a kind of real freedom of movement and freedom of thought, and I think it really touches something in their brain.
It's just so much in it. It's quite a busy painting, and you're all the time when you're looking at it, you're just seeing things you've never seen before. The way, you know, the layers and everything building up, and you start trying to work out what did he do first? How did he do that? And there's little bits, and you think, right, well, he must have painted that on the end. And then you see a dribble that goes over the top of it. And you think, well, in that case, he must have been painting that really quite fast in order to get, you know, those sort of marks and things coming through. And it's just got a real energy and a real passion.
The beauty in this painting is in the shape of the panels, the material that's used, the way it's used, the way the painting has been built up. If you look at it, it's been on the floor and paint's been applied, then it's been held against a wall and the paint's been allowed to drip, and then the artist, Neale himself, has sprayed letters and various forms on the panels. So it's really a process of layering.
It's fantastic. I mean, if I could do this, you know, I'll stop doing illustration and I'll just do this. I've been quite happy. I mean, I am. I'm very, very jealous of this picture. I'm very jealous of his work. I'd love to paint like him.
Mid-March, and Neale's in Cardiff's Boot Square to paint again for the Manic Street Preachers. This time it's to publicise the launch of a new album, and it's in the public gaze.
Someone in Sony Marketing came up with a really nice idea that they would like to see Neale working in process and actually getting to do a performance as well as creating a work. And we're all very excited about this because it's not something you usually can see, art in the making.
Just as he's getting into the swing, the artist's choice of words brings the attentions of the site owner, who gives him an ultimatum.
Well, that was close, wasn't it? He was that close to being pulled. Well, he did pull it, but he came back to the brink. With a bit of compromise.
He might come back and pull it again.
Well, we'll see tomorrow now. If it's still up again, they can always come back tomorrow and say, right, that's it! Down.
Prophetic words, but then Neale's been here before. All that remains of the work is the paint that had trickled through the cracks in his panels.
Why me?
They take me down now, so apparently we're going to have to find out why and where.
But you know why?
don't push me, Emery. I've got a breaking point, you know. Well, yeah, we don't know why, because when we left yesterday, everything was fine. It was all kosher, yeah. And we sorted out the offensive words, and here we go again. Ugh. Left my pot of paint.
still gets you every time.
He's as far removed from the art gallery, lounge lizardy sort of person as you could hope to meet. He's a bloke. He doesn't particularly suck up to the right people and that sort of thing, which is immensely refreshing.
Art is something that appeals, something that is good to look at. You do not have to have a painting that looks like a house or a cat. Art is something visual to look at. It's a shape, it's a form, it's a texture, and I find his work invigorating. It's full of life.
Like Edwin Munch. Who's that?
When they put the show up and then there was a swear word, and one of the counsellors came in and said, you know, you've got to take that picture down. And Neale just said, hey, hang on a minute, don't worry about it. He was quite calm and went upstairs. And all of a sudden they heard some hammering. She just hammered out the word and I just, oh, fantastic. I mean, you know, he's just got no worries and probably in hammering out the word, he said more than the actual word did itself.
Well, a professional artist does a job, you know, just like this manic thing, yeah?
Yeah.
It's a job to be done, and it's got to be done to the best of my, and I, you know, that is what I'm doing. Like, and I haven't got time to sort of show any, I suppose, emotion with it, for a better word, because it's now what I do, like.
So what's the most important thing in your life?
You've got terrible handwriting, haven't you?
It's rubbish, isn't it?
Right, yeah. I mean, that to me is fantastic, because I haven't got a clue what you're doing. You want to come down on the billboard and do a bit of work on it?
Do a bit of shorthand, yeah? What do you want me to
say? What's the dirtiest thing you think of?
I can't do that. Bollocks. Bastard. Yeah.
And got to finish off with the C word.
There you go.
I hope we're all learning this at home, kids. Look at those. That's disgusting. That's true. You know, this is a good example of what art could be, you know, well be, is that one interpretation for one person and a completely different interpretation for everybody else.
Neale finally gets the confiscated painting back, and with just 3 days to go before it's unveiled to the press, he moves into Cardiff Warehouse to finish the work.
Typical man that loves Adolf Hitler, then he's just gonna come fucking down on me, innit? Come back on me, like. You know, there's something, one more thing to go on here. But actually, it's loads of things. If there is life after death, then they, you know, say all the previous artists at work are up there and they'd all shout it down them, Howells, draw us a cock, will you? So, you know, you draw a cock, or draw us a wheel of a van, or draw us a hand. Well, I want to finish it off saying fine, no, fuck. But it's a case of going up to Friday and then, you know, and then saying, right, can I have that, everything down again? If I put my next loves Adolf Hitler, then it's just gonna come fucking down on me, innit? Come back on me, like. You know, there's something, one more thing to go on here. Well, actually, it's all these things. If there is life after death, then they, you know, say all the previous artists are working up there and they'd all shout it down, Howells, draw us a cock, will you? So, you know, you draw a cock, or draw us a wheel of a van, or draw us a hand. Well, I want to finish it off saying a fine no fact, but it's a case of going up tomorrow, Friday, and then, you know, and then they're saying, right, can't have that, everything down again. Reviewing it from being bars. You wouldn't be told, would you? You had to go and write the word fact. Not where you are now. It's, yeah, but I mean, you know, you compare this to what was happening last weekend on the TV when we had images of Rwanda and people dying of AIDS and, you know, that what was going on out there, like, and in the whole scope on Earth, somebody found the word fuck offensive, you know. Sad. The inspiration for this was red and white. I started off with those two colours. I just worked from there then. They don't know jack shit about art. They must start them off when you join a newspaper or something. They say, alright, then start going for the bottom. You can work on the arts. And then they usually work their way up to sports.
What's the piece called?
Oh no, there's a thought, we haven't had time to title it, we've been so busy with it. This is a painting, I think, for the 21st century, with all 21st century ideas and slogans in it. And anyway, you know, so some people, yeah, thought that's not what we wanted, and I actually stole it. If I get attention to myself, then I've usually got attention for the work. And it's primarily, again, about the work, so it's my job to make sure that the work is seen. Didn't expect to get my arse out, but, you know, you've got to go with the flow, haven't you? It was really nice getting that wind on your cheeks. You know, I think I should be doing that more often. Exposing myself there, getting that breeze on your bum.
2 hours later, the painting's been taken again.
They haven't even bothered to unscrew it. They've just ripped it off the wall. Lazy bastards. Well, it's gone and it's lasted an hour longer than we thought it would. We don't know where it's gone yet. Hard work succeeds in shocking public. Controversial work covered in obscenities and owned by manic street preachers were at the centre of an investigation last night. La 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 la. But no picture. No picture, which is what I'm interested in, is to actually get a visual out there, but they obviously decided it would be a bad idea to show it. Fuck's sake, who's done all that? Somebody's paper for my work, man.
The good news is that Neale's landed a solo exhibition in London, his first outside Wales. A local benefactor has given him use of his premises to prepare work for the show.
Well, this is what I've been slaving over. You know, it's taking on lots of different forms. But this is what was exciting. Okay, so, you know, it's still not finished yet, so whatever. But this is what I enjoyed when I'd done it.
We got, so if we can just concentrate on this part by you, right? So you sort of just quite close up to it, yeah? Not that close, but close-ish. And then you just pull yourself away slowly like that. And it's for some reason, it must be the size of this thing, because it's 12 by 12, and it's just the way it fits in there. You get a sense of, it's incredible. It's like I was trying to work it out, you know, it's like the guy is expanding and the size is collapsing. So you get this sort of weird wave as you walk away from it.
Oh, well, I've always thought Neale should be in London, he should be in New York. And then someone from a very small gallery who really, really loved Neale's work said he knew someone who was opening an interesting new space. And on the basis of that, we decided on a late spring, early summer show. I think for Neale, it's a very important milestone.
I've probably been thinking about this show too much. And I think that's why a lot of the work I've done in the last couple of weeks, or maybe in the last week or so, been so hard going. See, look at that thing. I mean, you know, what can you do with that, Em? Look at it.
You don't like it.
But look at it, like. I mean, look at that. Like, you know, I have tried to improve that. And that is what I've come up with. And this, that tells you that, you know, I'm definitely in need for new inspiration. Sometimes when you paint, then you can go through a way of working, and whatever you touch, like, do you know what I mean? Feels right, like you're always doing right things. And when you haven't got that, that's what you fucking end up with. Look at it. Look, it's.
Because it's the first thing we've shown outside, properly outside Wales, you know. With such large work as well.
Very rare now that you see big pieces, you know, because people's studios are so small nowadays that, you know, they're actually producing really small work. It's got a very big chance of cracking it in London.
The old work is getting a good look in. It's about the work. Not so much about me. And, you know, some of these works have been locked away, like, fucking been suffocating and things like that. So, especially the big one up there.
I now have come across people who I think have been influenced by Neale. He is actually kind of affecting art here, which is exciting in itself. One would hope that he'll make his name and make a mark in other countries, because he thinks of himself as an international global artist, and he is.
I suppose we've learned a lot in a short space of time, say, from the billboard to where we are now. We're going on, we're going. We've got this tonight, and in 2 weeks' time we go to Belfast, so it's a completely different thing as well.
We're just so lucky to have him. And sometimes we'll think, oh, he should stay in Wales, and then other times we'll just get so annoyed with what I read in the paper and what's going on and people's attitudes. I just think, go where people understand what you're doing.